Hi, today I'm going to show you how to make these circular flower ribbon bows. These are great to use for hair barrettes, or you can make them into a brooch, or they can be decorations on apparel. To begin with, you're going to need a needle and thread. Already have your needle and thread in your needle and knotted at the end so it's ready for you. And then you will need 1 yard of 3/8 inch ribbon. You'll start by making your first loop. Hold the end under your thumb and bring the next piece around and just keep holding it under your thumb each time you come around. You're going to need to go around. I'm not going back and forth. I'm going around. Picture that there's a rubber ball under here and you're wrapping around it. And you continuously come around. Each time you come around, you tweak it off to the side of the previous loop. If you don't like one of your loops, it looks like it's bigger or smaller than the others, just undo that one and re-loop it. Again, keep holding this under your fingers here because that's your center point where it's holding everything together. And just loop it around. So this is about a yard of ribbon, which will give you a nice, fully round flower here. Once you get everything looped around, you're going to take your needle and thread, go straight down in the center here where you were holding all the pieces together. Go down it once, and then you're going to come back up, oh, maybe about 1/8 of an inch away from where you went down the first time. So if you missed catching one of the ribbons, you get it the second time. Just come back up through here. And I'm going to go down one more time just to make sure I've got it nice and tight. This is pretty much done. And then I will knot this off. I could put a flower in the middle of this one and it would be finished, but I want to do a second layer on top of this. So I'm going to knot this off. This is why you needed to have your needle and thread already knotted off and ready for you, because you can't let go of what you just finished looping. Said, but I could put a flower in the middle of that and it would be done and just mounted onto my barrette. But I want to put another layer on top. So I've got another ribbon and I'm going to make loops the same exact way. But I want it to be a little bit smaller than this. So make your first loop and kind of lay it on top to make sure it's the size you want before you start making all of it. And then just come around in circles the way you did with the first one. You'll just keep coming around on top of it. Hold all those ribbons together under your thumb. And continue doing this until you get everything looped. You can do almost any color combination that you can imagine for these little barrettes. They look great. You can put a pin back on it, make a brooch for your grandma or your mom. You can use them to make and put onto t-shirts the way you would a yo-yo. You can make a little flower garden on a shirt or a sweatshirt to wear. Okay, so I come all the way around. This one, I started with a yard of this one also. I'm going to have a little bit more ribbon than I want on this one. So I'm going to snip it off, the extra, but I'm not going to cut it off until I get this sewn together. So I don't have to worry about letting go. So in the middle of it here, I'm taking my needle and thread, and I'm just going to sew in the center of it. Again, the second time I go through it, I do it about 1/8 of an inch away from the first time I went down, just in case I missed any of the ribbons the first time. I'll catch it on my second time through. Okay, and then I will knot this off. And we will trim off the extra here. And the extra ribbon here. Now I will put these two together. To do so, I'm just going to put a little bit of low melt glue in the middle of my polka dots. My sheer ribbon will go right on top of it in the center. I'm going to cover up those threads by putting a flower in the very middle of it. So I've got my little flower, put a little bit of glue on the back of it. Glue this straight in the center. Now this can be put onto a barrette, an alligator clip. I'm going to have it put onto a headband. This is our basic half inch headband that I've wrapped with the glitter ribbon, and I'm going to glue it off to the side here so it's not straight on top. So just put a little bit of glue on the back of the bow, flower, whatever you want to call it, and we'll just tap it down, and this one is done. You can also put this onto a barrette clip. You can use the basic French clips, or you can use alligator clips. I do recommend, though, covering the top of the barrette with the same ribbon that you just made your flower in, so that if any of the metal shows through, it will not show because you've got it covered with the ribbon. So if I'm going to do that, then all I need to do is, again, put some glue at the back of my flower, place it in the center. And if you want, you can anchor it with a couple more pieces at the ends, but this one is done also. That's how quick and easy these are to make. You can do a variation of doing a pinwheel on this, which is still going to be wrapping around and around, but each time you do the point, instead of going straight this way, you will tweak it into a pinwheel every time you come around. You'll end up only doing maybe about 5 or 6 points, because this will take up more distance because of the way that you're turning it. But you'll use the same technique of going back and forth and around, but you will turn the ribbon to get that pinwheel point. And then again in the center, you will use your needle and thread to stitch it right in the middle here, put a flower or a button in the center, and glue it onto your barrette back. And there you go. Have fun. We've got all the ribbons you need. Have questions, please give us a call or stop in and we'll help you out. Thank you.